Now the barrier island has two sides. You have the beach side where the ghost crab lives, and then you have the marsh side where the mud is, and in between is called the hammock. When I first heard that word, I thought it was a place to take a nap on a Sunday afternoon. But it's not that kind of hammock. It's a hill. A hammock is a hill. It is the oldest part of the barrier island, and it has the tallest live oak trees with the most gnarly and crooked limbs and Spanish moss hanging down. And if you look up in the limbs, you just might see a big black bird called a vulture. Now, vultures are scary and creepy, I know, but they really are quite gentle, and they'll never bother you, they'll never harm you. But like all creatures in the coastal ecosystem, they have a way of defending themselves if they ever feel threatened. So if you're walking through the hammock on Sapelo, underneath the crooked limbs of a tall live oak, you better keep your eyes open for a big black bird. He's got a nasty habit that's a little absurd. Watch out before it's too late. If he gets too close, he regurgitates. I'm talking vulture vomit on my head. 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 I should have brought my umbrella instead. I got vulture vomit on my head. As gross as that sounds to you and me, the projectile vomit of semi-digested meat. It's the turkey vulture's only real means of defense. If you think of it that way, it starts to make sense. So pay attention, let there be no doubt. You don't wanna be around when he lets breakfast out. I'm talking vulture vomit on my head. Louder! Vulture vomit. Vomit. Vulture vomit. I should have brought my umbrella instead. I got vulture vomit on my head. Well, this is so disgusting. I've heard people insist that we would all be better off if vultures did not exist. Now, don't you listen. That's a bunch of malarkus. You see, vultures are nature's way of recycling a carcass. Now, a carcass is a dead animal. That's what the vulture eats. That's what the vulture consumes. And I know it sounds gross, but remember, everything works together in a coastal ecosystem. The sun shines down on the smooth cordgrass, which gives it energy to grow. Then the fiddler crab eats the smooth cordgrass, which gives it energy to dance. Then when the fiddler crab dies, the vulture swoops down and eats the fiddler crab, which gives it energy to fly. And anything that's left of the body of the dead fiddler crab decomposes and turns back into marsh mud. Pretty cool, huh? I'm talking vulture vomit on my head. Louder! Vulture vomit. Let me hear you. Vulture vomit. Vulture vomit. I should have brought my umbrella instead. I got vulture vomit on my head. Sing it! Vulture vomit. Vulture vomit on my head. mosquito burrito, brother!